So today we are going to discuss about the microbiology of evaporated milk. We have already covered microbiology of sweetened condensed milk and what are the manufacturing operation of all these products, what are the standard of these two products we have already discussed in our last class. So we have already defined evaporated milk in our last class. As all of you know, that evaporated milk is unsweetened condensed milk, and it is how it is different from the sweetened condensed milk. In sweetened condensed milk, additionally, we are adding some amount of sugar in that. So evaporated milk is known as unsweetened condensed milk, and it is a self-stable canned milk product. What is happening in this? We are simply removing moisture present in your milk. 60% water will be removed from the system, and thereafter standardization and proper homogenization, it will be filled in a tinned container, and thereafter it will be commercially sterilized at 115 to 118 degree centigrade for 15 minutes. Nowadays, people have started giving USC treatment to these products just to maintain or just to retain its original quality. And in that case, people are giving high temperature, that is 135 to 150 degree centigrade for a fraction of a second, depending upon the initial bacterial load of your raw milk. So what is happening in this product? After the water has been removed from the product, it is chilled, then some kind of stabilizer is used in the system. Thereafter, homogenization will be done and canning, packing, and thereafter the final sterilization will be given to the product. So the evaporated milk is generally produced by removing half of the milk moisture by evaporation process. And it is generally used for cooking purposes because it is very easy to store, and it curdles less easily when heated compared to the other milk. Because we have already given a severe heat treatment during its manufacturing operation. So because of these advantages, people are preferring to use evaporated milk for preparation of different kind of food item in their daily diet. When it is unopened, what is happening in that case? It can be kept at room temperature for 6 months. And the keeping quality of evaporated milk, it depends upon the storage temperature, which is relatively on the high side in tropical countries like our India. So it all depends upon the temperature you are maintaining during storage. And the quality will also depends upon the storage condition. So generally it has been observed that the number of spores in the treated sample are very low, and they could germinate into vegetative cells, which could reach population high enough to cause spoilage or constitute food safety risk within a few days. So in any dairy product, or especially when you are going for high temperature treatment, in that case, you have to minimize the total contamination level, especially for spore-forming microorganisms. Because whenever they will get a suitable environment, the spore present in the system, even in a small number, they will start converting into vegetative cells. And ultimately, it will be responsible for creating abnormal flavor, taste, and sometimes some kind of severe type of spoilage problem in your final product. So we have to keep all these things in our mind before going for our manufacturing of this particular product. Now it is very important to know the composition of evaporated milk. the main thing is fat, that is 9%. Total solid is 31%. And milk SNF 22%, protein 8.3, lactose 12.2, ash content is 1.5. So simply, you should have idea about the composition of this particular product. What is the difference between sweetened condensed milk, because you are adding some amount of water in that. So evaporated milk, why we are producing, what are the specialties in different kind of evaporated milk, and what are the main features. So it is a concentrated and a sliced milk product, having a concentration twice that of a standard milk. So what is the composition of a standard milk? You all have idea about the composition, that is 4.5% fat and 8.5% SNF automatically. If you are doubling that, you will get this evaporated milk. The method of manufacturing evaporated milk involves a standardization. I have already told you that as soon as you are procuring milk from different sources, you have to chill it below 4 degrees centigrade just to restrict the growth of different contaminating microorganisms. Thereafter, you have to go for a clarification process, filtration process. Then, whatever product you are going to manufacture, accordingly, you have to standardize the whole lot. Thereafter, you have to choose a particular type of heat treatment to which should be applicable during the manufacturing of that product. Then evaporation of the milk under reduced pressure, especially the temperature you have to maintain during the evaporation is in between 60 to 65 degrees centigrade, because pressure you have to reduce inside your calendria or inside your vacuum pan. So it is very important, and because of this, you can retain most of the nutritious item present in your milk. So evaporated milk, after that, what is happening? We have to homogenize it to make it stable, and also it will prevent separating during a storage or during the cooling of your product. So this step is very important, and homogenization will be done after giving proper heat treatment or condensing process. So as a result of severe processing treatment, it is having characteristic cooked flavor and a characteristic color. You will get a typical type of color of evaporated milk, as well as sometimes you will get cooked flavor also in that product. And the shelf life of canned evaporated milk is about 1 year when it is stored at ambient temperature without opening your seaming. So, but in practice, the product can be kept for longer period. If you are keeping your product at low temperature, you can even go for longer period than 1 year. Then dairy plant should ensure that adequate hygiene should be maintained during the whole manufacturing process. And it is just to reduce the incidence of spore-forming bacteria, which are very important, especially in high heat treated product. So you should always keep in your mind that whatever raw material you are collecting, that must have a good quality or must possess good microbiological standard. And thereafter, contamination of a storage tank, pipelines, and from air sources should be prevented. And it is also recommended that higher temperature should be applied in milk processing, because if some number or some a specific type of microorganism is there in the system, that will be destroyed or inactivate if you apply a higher temperature during the processing treatment. So I have already told you about the ultra high temperature treatment, 138 degrees centigrade for 2 to 4 seconds. And it is just to preserve or retain our nutrients and just to maintain or give a better flavor to your product. So in this table, the flow diagram of manufacturing process is given. Sometimes you have to add some type of a stabilizer just to stabilize the whole system. Thereafter, you have to give this preheating treatment. Evaporation is done. Thereafter, standardization will be done, filtering, homogenization, and after that, canning and sterilization will be done of the final product after giving proper packing. Now, why we are manufacturing this evaporated milk? It is a good source of calcium. It is also a good source of protein, contains good amount of vitamins, and government regulations also ensure that vitamin A, D, you can fortify in your product. And whatever product you will get have all sort of vitamins present in it. Now, please, you all are requested to mute your mobile. I'm always repeating, Raja, mute your mobile. Now, some of the health benefits. Presence of calcium, which is in high amount in these products, concentrated products, it makes teeth strong and healthy. It also provides ample amount of energy to our whole system. Then strengthen bones. It also gives a smoother skin. Natural skin will be softened, and presence of calcium adds in bone teeth, bone health. Now some general benefits are also there. It does not require refrigeration, easy to store, higher concentrate of vitamins and nutrient fortified. Then evaporated milk is suitable for infant feeding since it makes a soft curd which is easily digested. Why it is like this? We have already given a severe heat treatment during its manufacturing. So whatever components are there in the system, it will provide a soft curd. It will be responsible for soft curd of your final product produced. Now, what is the effect of processing on the microflora? Because we are mainly concerned with the microbiology of microbiological things present in this particular product. So what is happening during manufacturing? Water is removed. And what type of instrument we are using in our dairy industry? You must have heard the name of multiple effect evaporator. So what is happening in this method and why it is preferred over other conventional method or other methods used in different industries? So because of its energy efficient and you can easily control the whole system. So mainly we are using falling film evaporator. So what is happening in this and what is the main feature of this? You can minimize the total energy required for the whole processes. How you can minimize and how you can get a very energy efficient system in the manufacturing operation. The vapor, which is the most important thing in manufacturing operation, producing the first effect that will be the utilized for heating the second effect, calendria, or in multiple effect evaporator. And because of that, it produces a gradual decrease in temperature that is in between 70 to 80 degrees centigrade in the first effect to about 40 degrees centigrade in the last effect. And the vacuum, which is maintained in these calendrias, is maximum in the lowest temperature evaporation side, and the milk flows from higher to lower temperature. So it is, this method is very effective and it is widely used in our dairy industry. So whatever concentration you want in your product, you can manufacture within no time. So This method is nowadays preferred over other methods. But one very important thing is there in this process, the lower temperature range within the within the lower temperature effect of evaporator, it will permit the growth of thermophilic and mesophilic spores. And there may be chances to reach high number in the multiple effect evaporator during prolonged production run. So what is there in this type of process? We are simply lowering down the temperature during the evaporation process, and at the same time we are doing the, or we are continuing this operation under vacuum. So if your mill is contaminated with thermophiles or mesophiles, automatically they will get a suitable environment inside the calendria or in multiple effect evaporator, and ultimately it, the number of these microorganisms will be increased and responsible for creating so many abnormal conditions. So as all of you know that these products which we are producing in case of concentrated milk, in case of sweetened condensed milk, it is almost sterilized, because after packing we are going for or you can say after canning we are going for the final sterilization treatment. But here in case of evaporated milk, they are not commercially sterilized, although it is favorable medium for the microbial growth, and the spoil is caused by heat resistance microorganisms present in the raw milk like bacillus, enterococci, or whatever post-processing contaminants are there like pseudomonas and species of enterobacteriaceae. They are the problem creating microbe, and they can grow after production of this particular product. If your product is stored at even at low temperature, that is 7 degrees centigrade. So the shelf life of unsweetened condensed milk varies from few days to few weeks, depending upon the degree of post-processing contamination. What type of condition you have given after manufacturing, or what type of environmental condition, the packaging material you are using, or what type of seaming you are doing, or some kind of, sometimes you will get some number of microbes will gain entry into the system during that standardization or homogenization process. So whatever pipelines or whatever equipments you are using, that should be properly sanitized before start of the manufacturing system of evaporated milk. The severity of heat treatment used during the manufacturing process and the temperature control during cooling and storage, that will also dictate the number and type of microorganisms in the final product. So the pattern of spoilage is same as pasteurized milk, although the water activity level of this product is lower compared to that. And automatically, you will get more advantage in case of evaporated milk compared to milk. So generally, it has been observed that some of the thermophilic species, they can grow even at a temperature level of 70 degrees centigrade. So it is very important to control this particular type of thermophiles. And for that, effective cleaning of the whole system before start of operation, then proper CIP system is very much required, just to maintain the standard of plant hygiene. And just by doing this, you can maintain a very sanitized condition, and you can minimize the overall bacterial load of your product. So after production, it is finally filled into can, which is hermetically filled. And thereafter, in some cases, we are giving sterilization using batch retards or continuous sterilizers. So in that, we are giving 115 degrees centigrade for 15 to 20 minutes, or in some cases 120 degrees centigrade for 10 minutes. And it is mainly used in our traditional, during traditional manufacturing process. But nowadays, people have started, and people have started recommending a newer kind of processing method, which I have already told you, that is the UHT treatment, in which you are giving a very high temperature time combination, and it should be followed by aseptic packaging in cans or cartons. So what temperature we are applying in this? Heating at 130 degree centigrade for 30 seconds and 150 degree centigrade for less than 1 second may be used in few cases. And it all depends upon your preliminary conditions of handling, which you have given during transportation, during a storage, and during pre-treatment of your mill. So retorted canned mill is commercially sterilized, and there are possibility of surviving heat resistance spore of Bacillus styrothermophilus. So these spores, which is very important as far as the our UHT system is concerned, these spores do not germinate unless the can are again stored at higher temperature, that is more than 43 degrees centigrade. And evaporated milk, which are aseptically packed, may be recontaminated during filling, packing, if proper hygienic procedure used in filtering, filling other UHT milk product are not properly used. So whatever time temperature you are giving during these treatments, that are sufficient to inactivate all sort of contaminating microorganisms. Simply you have to have control over the spore, number of spore forming microorganisms, and just by doing that you can get a good final product. So these are the multiple effect evaporating system. Jitendra, please mute your mobile. So this is process diagram of evaporated milk, and this is for multiple effect evaporator. So there are three number of calendria are there. You can see the arrangement of pipelines inside the calendria, and whatever vapor is generated from first effect, that will be utilized in the second effect of calendria, and again the whatever vapor produced inside that calendria, that will be collected in this second effect vapor separator, and ultimately it will go in the into the third effect calendria, and finally you will get the evaporated milk produced in the system. So this is also a diagram, process diagram of evaporated milk, and whatever condensate will come out, that will be again utilized for the next calendria. So this is all about the manufacturing operation, and this multiple effect calendria or evaporating system is widely used in our dairy industry. So now, microbiological defect. So a very few spoilage reports are available in commercially sterilized canned evaporated milk, but sometimes under processing or post-processing, contamination may create some time of abnormality in your product. So some species are very important: Bacillus styrothermophilus and Bacillus coagulans, Bacillus lichenoformis. These are the microorganisms which may survive the heat treatment given during the evaporating system and the temperature which you are applying in the manufacturing of evaporated milk. Bacillus subtilis produces non-acid curd and produce brownish liquid with a bitter taste. Bacillus megatherium is responsible for coagulation problem accompanied with cheesy odor and gas. So you have to remember the name of this Bacillus megatherium and Bacillus subtilis. Occasionally, a defect like blowing of cans problem is observed, and It is associated with the growth and activity of putrefactive spoilage organism, that is Clostridium group. Clostridium botulinum and Clostridium perfringens are the main group which are responsible for creating this kind of problem. So now the common bacterial defects are listed here, bloating, and it is caused by gaseous fermentation, then bacterial coagulation, then some type you will get off flavor due to bacterial problem, which will cause or responsible for producing bitter flavor, and it is very frequently observed in different kind of evaporated milk produced. Now blots of evaporated milk. It is mainly caused by gaseous fermentation in commercial packing, and it is most serious bacterial defect found in evaporated milk. And what is happening in this? The commonly responsible organisms are not always responsible for this. Sometimes it is because of post-processing contamination of evaporated milk. So we have to have a very good control after giving proper heat treatment or sterilization treatment to our product. There should not be any sort of post-processing contamination. Otherwise, this type of problem will be observed in our final product. So serious outbreaks of blots problem in commercially produced evaporated milk is mainly produced by the higher heat resistance microorganisms. And it is mainly because of anaerobic bacteria, which are from butyric acid group. And they are also responsible for creating putrefactive condition in your product. And sometimes you will get gas formation, and this gas formation is also accompanied by putrid odor, that is also known as foul odor. So automatically you should have to control all these things. So the responsible organisms are, I have already listed in last slide, but here one specific type of microorganism is also responsible for creating abnormal condition in your evaporated milk. Plactridium foetidium. So you have to remember the name of this particular spore forming bacteria, which is motile in nature, and at 32 degrees centigrade, this particular microorganism ferment milk in 4 days under anaerobic condition. So it is also very vulnerable condition. So there should not be these type of microorganisms in the system. The milk first curdles and curd gradually digest, leaving a clear yellow liquid similar in appearance to butter. And the fermentation, which is occurred because of the growth and activity of this particular microorganism, it is accompanied by the production of intense foul putrefactive odor, and it is mainly because of production of hydrogen sulfide. And this organism can survive at 118 degrees centigrade for 15 minutes. So you can well imagine the condition of this particular microorganism, how lethal and how they can responsible for surviving and creating abnormal condition, abnormal spoilages problem to your final product. Now coagulation of this evaporated milk. This type of coagulum found in so many outbreaks, and it varies from sweet curdling to a sour curd. And what is happening in this? A intense bitter curd is produced. And in some cases, you will get a sweet curd, and there is no bitter taste, and no acid was developed, and curd was varying firmness with absence of weighing off. It is mainly because of the Bacillus cereus, Bacillus coagulans. You must have idea about the sweet curdling process, and these microorganisms are very important to restrict at initial level. And what is the survival requirement? these organisms were not destroyed by a 10 minute exposure to 80 degree centigrade, but failed to survive 112 degree centigrade. So automatically you have to use a higher temperature level during the manufacturing operation. Now bitterness in evaporated milk, sometimes you will get this type of problem, and it is because of the protein breakdown and formation of peptone and other decomposition product is responsible for giving bitter flavor to your product. And the coagulum was formed, and sometimes you will see a striking whiteness in the final product. So very white color you will get in your product. And sometimes the content had weighed off, some amount of water will be extracted from the whole system. And this was practically clear, and acidity was normal in between 0.35 to 0.4%. As inoculum with a sterile milk, it did pure culture of very small spore forming rods, and these rods are responsible for this type of problem. In some cases you will get fishy flavor, that is because of the Proteus ischyromys, especially found in evaporated milk product. So it is mainly responsible for coagulation with fishy flavor in your product. Now, control of microbiological defect. So these are the microorganisms: Bacillus cereus, Bacillus lichenoformis, coagulans, Subtilis, Asterothermophilus, Clostridium perfringens, because they have ability to survive higher temperature. Sometimes it is coming from the raw material. If faulty processing condition is there, automatically it will come from outside after getting proper heat treatment. So automatically we should avoid such conditions during the manufacturing operation, and we should minimize the total number of these microorganisms, which are mainly responsible for creating so many abnormalities in high heat treated product. So now it is also very important to go for different testing methods, which are very important. So you have idea about standard plate count method. So just by using that method, you can have idea about the total bacterial load of that product. And you know, this evaporated milk should not have any type of pathogenic microorganisms, and the commercially it should be sterilized in nature. So keeping in mind, you should go for a standard agar plate method. Thereafter, you should also go for sterility test and direct microscopic count. Although this method have a little value for evaporated milk, and there is very low number of bacteria in this product, so this direct microscopic count, that is breed method, is not so important in case of evaporated milk. Thereafter, anaerobic agar plate count, it is very important, because most of the cases you will get that your product is contaminated or some Clostridium group is there in the system, and ultimately it will responsible for creating my problem. Then examination of thermophilic bacteria is very important in this evaporated milk. So just by going these testing method, you can have idea about the microbiological quality of your final product. Now some pathogens are also may present in the system, and ultimately responsible for transferring some kind of diseases to human being. But the time temperature combination we are giving during the manufacturing operation is sufficient to inhibit most of the microorganisms, as